B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. I don't know about you, but one of my favorite snacks is a crisp, juicy apple. Often I slice it and add some peanut butter or honey, and it is so delicious. Have you ever sliced an apple but then walked away and forgotten about it? When you go back to eat it, you might notice it has turned brown and mushy. Not so delicious anymore. From our last lesson, we know that a substance's physical properties are those that we can observe without changing it, and its chemical properties are those that involve changing the matter. Thinking about that, which of these properties changed when I sliced the apple? What happened that made it turn brown when it was sitting out on the counter? In today's lesson, we are going to build on our last lesson on physical and chemical properties as we explore what happens as we change the properties of a substance. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to discuss characteristics of physical and chemical changes, use evidence to identify if a chemical or physical change occurred. When I sliced my apple earlier, I didn't change the chemical composition of my apple. It tasted the same, and besides being cut in half, it was exactly the same. This was an example of a physical change. A physical change is any change to a substance that changes the form without changing the substance. What you start with and what you end with is the same, it just looks different. Often, but not always, physical changes are reversible. If I take an ice cube tray and place it in the freezer, the water will freeze. What happens if I take it out of the freezer and leave it in the sink? The water will melt back into a liquid. Phase changes are physical changes. Another example is dissolving a solid in water. As we learned in a previous lesson, adding a solid to water just means that the particles of the solid spread out so much that you can't see them with the naked eye. There is a process called distillation that allows you to remove a dissolved solid from water. Dissolving a solid is another example of a physical change. What about cutting paper? Do you think that is a physical change? It is. The properties of the paper are not changing. However, unlike dissolving a solid or freezing a liquid, cutting a paper is not reversible. It's important to remember that while many physical changes are reversible, they are not all reversible. So if a change is not reversible, you may need to use other clues to decide. Let's revisit our apple from earlier one more time. The act of slicing it in half was a physical change. However, when we left it on the counter, it eventually turned brown and mushy. At this point, it no longer tasted or smelled like it did when it was first sliced. When the apple started to turn brown and mushy, it was undergoing a chemical change. A chemical change is a change that occurs when a substance becomes a different substance. In the case of the brown apple, once it turned brown, there was no way to return it back to the original apple. When trying to identify a change as a chemical change, there are some key pieces of evidence that you can look for that will help. One indicator that a chemical change has occurred is the production of heat or energy, like when you burn a piece of wood in a fireplace and you end up with ash and carbon dioxide. Some other indicators include the production of gas in the forms of bubbles and fizzing, like adding baking soda and vinegar together to form carbon dioxide, water, and sodium acetate. And when leaves convert chlorophyll to other pigments, causing the leaves to change color in the fall. Why don't we spend a little time practicing identifying physical and chemical changes? When trying to decide, there are a few questions you can ask to help narrow it down. If you can answer yes to any of the following questions, then the change is a physical change. Did only the size or shape change? Was it a phase change? Can the change be reversed? Do you still have the same substance? What about chemical changes? If you can answer yes to any of the questions below, then it is a chemical change. Was a new substance created? Was a gas created? Was energy or heat produced? Notice, I did not include color change in this list of questions. That is because color change is not always a good indicator. If you paint the walls of your room, the color changes, but it is still your room and therefore a physical change. However, if rust forms on a metal, there is a color change, but it is a chemical change. Let's practice, shall we? Would you identify sugar dissolving in water as a physical or a chemical change? It is a physical change. What about wood rotting? Is that a physical change or a chemical change? It's a chemical change. Okay, let's try one more. Would you describe the digestion of food in your stomach as a physical or a chemical change? It is a chemical change. As we went through the lesson today, we reviewed the difference between physical and chemical changes and practiced identifying these changes. Our next lesson is a review and assessment of what you have learned during our States and Properties of Matter unit. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. Hey, hey.